गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. नाउ द ऑनलाइन टीचिंग इज़ वेरी मच ट्रेंडी फॉर विच वी रिक्वायर द टू नो अबाउट फ्यू ऑनलाइन टूल्स एंड फॉर दैट वी नीड टू नो हाउ वी कैन डील विद द ऑनलाइन फीडबैक फॉर्म और वी कैन क्रिएट सम ऑनलाइन क्विजेस. सो फॉर दैट वी नीड द गूगल फॉर्म. सो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू शो हाउ यू कैन create a Google form and using the settings you can change many things within the Google form. So in the google.com type Google form click on the first link click on the go to Google forms. So here you can see a few options where you have to click on the blank space. Okay, so when a blank Google form will be created with untitled form, you have to give the form title in this section and in this section also. Okay, so I'm taking a feedback form of this video. And I'm clicking on this, the same name will appear. Okay, so now here one option is given, that is collection of the email address. It will come only if your in the settings option the collect email addresses are enabled. Okay, so for that reason the email address is required. When the participant or the student will fill this form, they should be logged in through their Gmail account. So now you can write something here. You can write your name. Full name. And when I'll write the full name, it will automatically come to the short answer, right? Because the name can be a short answer. You can have the option to change the type of the answer. Okay, I'll show each type of the answer. Next, suppose you want the address. So address needs a paragraph, so a little bit longer answer you need. Then after that, next option is multiple choice. Suppose you want to make a quiz and you want to know some answer of something. So color of sky. So is it blue? Is it green? Is it red? Is it black? Okay, so I have given this and it should be selected as a multiple choice question. Now suppose you want to take more than one answer for the same question. I'm deleting this during day. I'm deleting, and the color can be blue and black in the day and the night. So for that reason you have to click on the checkbox so that the participant can click on both the options. And required fill, you have to check this required fill if you are making this particular point as a mandatory point. Fine. Next option I'm going, which is a drop down button. So suppose you want to select the state, or suppose age. So you do not want to know the direct age, you want to know some range of ages. So option one is from 18 to 10 to 20. Option two is 21 to 30. Option three is 30 to 50. and option 4 is more than 50. Okay, so this 4 options you are checking for the drop down option. Let me show you how it will be shown. See, the name, email address will come in this way. The name you have not made it mandatory, so that is why this star marks is not coming over there. Then address, which is a continuous paragraph, you can add. Next, the color of sky, 2 options can be selected. And then age, it is giving you the range. So this is how it will be appear. Next, I am showing you the option of the file upload option, where you can suppose taking some assignment. So assignment document you can take as a file option, upload option. Okay, so here you can choose any document if you want to take, except from the participant, then you should not check this. Otherwise you can check it, and you can specify which type of document is required, and you can also mention the size of the document, number of files and the maximum size. Suppose the number of files can be maximum number of files can be 5, so you can choose the 5, and the maximum file size should not be 10 MB. You can take as a 1 MB. 1 MB is enough to take a file. So this is how you can choose the file option, file upload option. Next option is the linear scale. Suppose you want to take some feedback, based on this you are checking this. Okay, so this is 1 to 5. So 1 to 5 is what it will be shown. As like as this, so the participant can choose any number, like minimum to maximum, as their option. Okay, so this is how the linear scale works. The next topic, point is multiple choice grid. So let me check on this. Suppose you want to check some rows and columns. So in the rows and columns, suppose you are checking row 1, column 1, then row 2, column 2, row 3, column 3, column 4. Okay, you want 3 rows and 4 columns. Fine. Your question may be anything. I'm not writing the question. So how it will look like? Just see. You can give some option, and from each and every row only one option can be selected. So this is how you can take a multiple option, multiple grid line option. Next question is the tick box grid. Tick box grid, as like as the multiple this option, just the student can check on the multiple option in a same row. Okay, so suppose you are adding 2 row and 4 columns. Fine. Now see how it will look like. So a participant can choose multiple option from there. Okay, I'm going back to the form. The next option is date option. Fine. So suppose you are giving date, you want to collect the birthday of the participant. okay? So you can choose this date so that they can upload their birthday by using the calendar. So the calendar will automatically appear. See, it will automatically appear the calendar by clicking on here. The participant can choose the date. Fine. And the last option is time option. Okay, so suppose you are asking some time, how it will look like? See, AM PM, in this format you can upload the time. So this is how all the options comes. Fine. Now I'm going to the next option, that is the import question. So using this import question, you can import a question from any other Google form. Suppose you have already created Google form earlier time, so you can import question from those Google form. It will help to minimize your time to create a new Google form. The next option is the title and the description. So suppose you do not ask anything, want to ask anything, you just want to give some instruction in the form of the text, then you can choose this option. It will appear just the title and the description. Description is optional. You can give the your instruction over there. Fine. And the thing is that in the next option is add image option. Here you can add any kind of image which will directly be shown into your Google form. Let me check whether there are any images are there or not. I'm not finding any images in my desktop. So let me take a image from let me take your image link. Copy image address. And I'm going back to here. By URL, I'm pasting the image URL, which will look like this, insert image. So it will directly appear the image over there. The next section is the add video section, which is very easy. You just go to the YouTube. Fine. So any video we can take. We can open a YouTube video. I'm just taking the, just right click on the video, and here you can get the copy video address, and then you just click on that option, paste it, and click on the search button. No video is coming. Just you take this URL. Okay, it came, select it, so it will directly appear. Fine. And the last option is the section option. The section option will help you to segregate the one section to the another section. Suppose you are making the section over there after the date, so just click on the section. The section 2 will appear. So this is suppose the multimedia section. So how it will look like, you just check here in the first page, what will come? what we have done, the first few options have appeared. Then we are clicking on the next option. Then as it is mandatory, you have to give something. I'm not clicking on anything because they are not mandatory now. Now see, in the next page the multimedia and the YouTube video have appeared. Okay, so this is how you can add the section. Fine, I'm leaving this part. Okay, so responses are now nil. I'll show how you can deal with the responses in the next video, as still now no responses have come. I'm going to the setting option. In the setting option, few settings, general settings are there. Suppose you want to collect the email address, then you have to check this. If you are allowing the participant to give only one response, then you check this. If the participant can edit after the submit, then you can check this. Otherwise, you leave it. See the summary chart and the text. If you want to show the old the responses to the new participant who are giving the response, then you check this. Otherwise, it is not necessary. Maximum size of all uploaded files, that is at as you have given the add upload option, the file uploading option, so you are getting this particular option. Otherwise, you will not get this option. So here you can select 1 GB, 10 GB, 100 GB, and 1 TB. So the minimum 1 GB you have to select. In the presentation, show progress bar. Show progress bar is applicable if you are selecting multiple section. So the student or the participant will know that how many pages will appear next. And the shuffle question, if you want to shuffle all the questions that you have given in the form, then you need this. Confirmation message is if you want to show some message after the submission to the participant, then you just write it there. And if you want to make it as a quiz, then you have to click on this. The quiz part I'll show in the next video. Fine. So this is all how to create a Google form. I hope that this video will help you a lot to create a basic Google form.